Alright, so this last tutorial I want to show you guys how to use the slope tool for graphical analysis. So you can see I have the position versus time graph on the top and a velocity versus time graph on the bottom. For this lab, I want you guys to actually calculate the velocity, and if you think of what we did in pivot, we used a position versus time graph. And if you think of the definition of velocity, it's change in position over time. So referring to the top graph, change in position over a change in time is actually the slope of that graph. So using the top graph, I'm going to find the slope. So it's real simple. Just tap anywhere on the graph and you'll get that to show up. This is kind of tricky, but the larger of the two boxes, the longer one, typically, that's the one I'll try to grab, so tap and hold, and then drag it, but you can see it just moved everything, so sometimes you have to play around, and this time it actually was able to highlight and spread out. So it's nice because it lets me choose or select the data I want to use. For instance, the beginning of this graph, it doesn't really look like that data fits the rest of the graph, so I'm not going to include that. So if I didn't want to include it, it looks like about to there would be a good starting point. And then I could highlight the entire thing. The numbers that are shown there, though, those aren't the slope. Those are just the times at which the highlighting part is stopping and ending. So if you actually see in the bottom left of this graph, there's a little icon that got highlighted. If you tap on that and then do apply curve fit, we want a linear fit, which it is on by default. And so that's great. The data is now shown on the graph. So if I look over at the data, I see the y-intercept formula, y equals mx plus b, and the slope of that is m. So the slope of this graph is 0.214. Now the thing that you have to recognize is that number, they didn't give us units, but this is a position versus time graph, so the units would be meters over seconds, and that makes sense because those are the units for velocity. It's a change in position in meters over a change in time in seconds. All right. Now, just for future reference, we could also kind of mess with the bottom graph, but I wouldn't want to do slope with the bottom graph. All right. Velocity is actually shown on the y-axis, so I wouldn't want to take the slope because that's something completely different. I could, though, if I wanted to, I could do the same thing I did before and highlight this. So if I tap on the screen, and you can see this one's being a little bit harder to drag and separate. Let's see if I can get it. Come on. There we go. If I highlight this, and I'm not going to include that beginning part either, I can actually use this tool feature again, but I'm not going to do curve fit. I'm going to do statistics. Why statistics? Because now what's kind of cool is the mean value. If you see second down right under samples, the mean value is actually telling me what the average data point is on the y-axis. And it says 0.212, and it actually gives us meters per second, which is really cool. So that actually agrees with the slope from the previous graph, which was the velocity for that graph as well. So be very mindful of which graph you're looking at. The slope for each graph doesn't mean the same thing. You need to slow down and think about it, okay? All right, so when you guys get this, of course, for the marble, go ahead and screenshot this and then add this into the lab report.